Hi guys, this is Yasir and welcome back to another video. In today's video, I will show you how to install Docker desktop app on your Windows computer. And for the people who are looking for like what are the requirements to run Docker desktop app on your Windows computer, I will get to those requirements during the installation process, so keep watching. And for the people who are interested in knowing more of the stuff related to Docker, like what are container images and volumes, I will explain those in very simple way towards the end of the video in a way that you will never forget, so keep watching the video till end. Now without any further ado, let's start. First of all, we will have to get setup file for Docker desktop app. For that, go to their official website www.docker.com, and once you are here, you can see this blue button that is saying download Docker desktop, and when you will hover your mouse over it, you will see different versions that are available to download. And for the Windows, we have two versions. I will come back to these a little bit later. And let's say Docker decides to change the interface of this website and this blue button is not more available here, then there is another documentation page where we can download different versions of Docker desktop app for the Windows, so you can also do that. I will add this link in the video description below, so you can get it there. But for the demonstration of this video, I will use this blue button here. So I will hover my mouse over this one, and you can see there are two versions available to download, AMD 64 and ARM 64. And if you are not sure what is the version of your Windows, simply go to the search bar and type in system information and open it up. And you will see this system type here. For my case, it is x64 based PC, and most probably it will be same for you as well. It means that it is AMD 64 version. But if your Windows is ARM based PC, then you will specifically see that ARM written here, but mostly it will be x64 based PC. For that, we have to download this AMD 64 version from here. Just simply click on this link here and it will start downloading that setup file. As I have already downloaded it, so I will cancel this one and let me bring that up. I already have this one downloaded. I will just simply double click on this one and then we will start the setup for installing Docker desktop app. When this pop-up appears, click on this yes button here and it will start the installation process. So let's wait for that. Now the installation process is running. It is recommended to enable this option because without it, Docker won't run successfully. And if you already have Docker containers on your Windows and you want to add them to this Docker desktop app after the installation, check this option. And if you want to have, of course, shortcut on the desktop for this Docker desktop app, you can enable this option as well. And after that, just click on this OK button and it has start to install this Docker desktop app on our computer. While it is installing, I would like you to like this video and subscribe to this channel because it will highly motivate me to create more engaging content. And now let's see what are the system requirements for running Docker desktop app. For that, again we will go to the documentation of Docker's. Again, on this page, if I scroll down a little bit, we can see the system requirements for running this Docker desktop app. And here you can see that the Windows should be at least Windows 10 or Windows 11, and that should be with 64-bit processor, and the RAM that is required for running Docker desktop app in smooth way is at least 4 GB. If you have these requirements, you are good to go to install Docker desktop app on your computer. Let's see where we are with the installation. So it is now installing. I will fast forward the video, and once the installation is complete, we will come back to this. Now the installation has been completed, so I will click on this close button here. Okay, now let's start Docker desktop app. For that, go to your search windows and type in desktop and just click on this Docker desktop and it will start running Docker desktop app. Let's wait for that. So now it is showing this Docker subscription service agreement, you will have to click on this accept here. And with this, our Docker desktop app is running. It will ask you to create an account on Docker. You will really not need that for now, so you can click on this skip button here. And now our app is starting, like our Docker engine is being starting, through which we can create container images and volumes. Let's start. Okay, so this is the interface of Docker desktop app. From here you can go to container section, images section and volume section. Let me briefly go over these things. The containers will actually act as operating system where you can install different kind of tools and softwares, and to install those software or tools you will need their setup files that are called images. Basically you will use images to install different tools or softwares on these containers. And then we have the volumes here, and actually volumes are really necessary because when you will be running apps or tools on your containers, there should be a volume attached to those tools, because without those volumes your tools will not be able to save data anywhere. So next time you will restart your computer and you will again run that same container, within those containers the tools, if there is no volume is attached to them, will lost all the saved progress that you have already may have saved. You have to keep in mind that volumes are really necessary and they are attached to the tools or software that you will install in these containers. That's all for this video. If you have any questions, do let me know in the comment section below. I will try to address them. And thanks for watching. Do like this video and subscribe to this YouTube channel for more engaging and useful content. Thanks.